Greetings. I am Dr. Janet Elder, principal of Crystal McAuliffe School, PS 28. I hope you enjoy watching our fall news production, capturing the great happenings here at PS 28.
Presents Krista McAuliffe News with Heaven Scarola, May Mansour, and the PS 28 tech team.
Hello, and welcome to Krista McAuliffe News. I'm Heaven Scarola.
And I'm May Mansour.
In today's program, Ayat Saleh and Gina Mercedes take a look at the new extended day program here at PS 28.
We'll also hear from Yasmin Quinones, who was on hand at the annual Halloween parade.
And we'll see how the fall sports teams fare this year. But first, our top story. The election results are in. This fall, our own May Mansour was elected Student Council President by the Middle School of PS 28. Eighth grader Crystal Rajpal Singh was elected Vice President, and each homeroom voted for a representative to the council. Complete election results will be displayed at the bottom of your screen. For a report, here's Christy Perez.
On Thursday, October 23rd, the PS 28 Student Council induction ceremony was held. Dr. Elder, Ms. Timmons, and Dr. Stringeil attended the ceremony. Parents of the Student Council nominees and students from grade 5 through 8 also attended. The students who were selected for Student Council were given a pin and presented on stage to the student body. Closing the ceremony, our President May Mansour gave her speech in which she promised to do her best for the students of PS 28. I spoke to Ms. Kavanaugh about the Student Council nominees and what we should be expecting this year.
How do you feel about the class representatives?
Well, the classroom representatives this year are very enthusiastic and dedicated, and I'm extremely positive that we're going to have a great year and very productive year. I'm excited.
What should we be expecting this year?
Well, we're going to be doing some of the old standards that we usually do. We're going to have our fundraisers, pennies for patients, probably our juvenile diabetes walk, and along with some new things. I don't want to give any secrets away or surprises, but I think you can look forward to some new programs this year.
I also spoke to our Vice President, Crystal Rajpal Singh, about improving our school and working as a team.
Do you think you and May will make a great team this year? Why?
Yeah, because we've been friends since sixth grade, and we're very responsible and organized.
How do you plan on helping May improve our school?
Well, me and May are practically going to do the same thing, so I'm always there when she needs me.
I'm Christy Perez here from the library speaking to the President of Student Council, May Mansour. How do you feel about being school president?
Well, I'm really proud of it. Like, it's really good to know that you have the whole school behind you, and it gives me the ability to kind of showcase the opinions of the student body. So I kind of feel like me, as well as the other student council representatives, were the voice.
Now that you're president, what will you do for our school?
Well, we just began. We really can't do much for November, considering the fact that we have half the time off. But we do have a lot of stuff scheduled for, you know, early winter, and there's actually a lot of stuff scheduled for 7th and 8th grade for the spring.
So were you nervous when you were seeing your speech?
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I rehearsed it so many times, like when we had practices, and even I would take it home, and I would call all my friends and like have them listen to it on the phone. But at the same time, when you have that many people staring at you, especially some of them being your friends and they're all smiling, it's really hard to keep a straight face and try not to mess up.
Do you classify yourself as a good school president?
I really wouldn't say that just yet. I'd like to think I am, but I mean, I just started this, and it's more of a team effort. It's me and the student council representatives. I get so much help from them. It's not really just me being a great student council president. It's us being like a good council all together.
I'm Christy Perez here from the library, and I've been speaking to President of Student Council, May Mansour. Back to you.
Well, congratulations to you and all the student council.
Thank you. For our next story, Gina Mercedes reports on the new extended day program that has many students engaged and learning after school.
This year, Crystal McAuliffe's Extended Day program is very different from Extended Day last year. Students had an abundance of possibilities to choose from. They were given the choice of participating in activities such as Latin American culture, robotics, the school newsletter, math and fantasy sports, and drama. All of these extracurricular activities are preparing students for testing in the spring. The activities are designed for students to learn and achieve while having fun and enjoying their time. Tech team producer Ayat Saleh spoke to teachers and students involved with the program.
Today I am on the set of Mr. Linares' Caribbean dancing program. So that sounds pretty interesting. What is it about?
Well, they're learning about some kind of music from the Caribbean. You know, they got the salsa, they call all the mambo from Cubans and Puerto Rican, fusion of the different rhythm, you know? And everybody now knows that merengue, salsa, and bachata, they are come from, from Africa, because it's percussion. Yeah. So from here, they already learn about the Mayans, the Aztecas, and Incas, and now they are learning from their new generation here in the American, 500 years ago.
Hi, Ms. Farrow. So I heard about your exclusive club. What is it about exactly?
It's called The Wide World of Art, and we're working on things to prepare for our up-and-coming art show. We're going to skip around a little bit. We're going to do some visual literacy so that the kids not only are prepared for the wide world we live in, but also the being visually creative helps to stimulate other thoughts in one's brain.
Today I'm on the set of Mrs. Yaboot's newest extended day program. So, Ms. Yaboot, what is it about?
Our program is called CMI, and it's an homage to CSI. What we do is we investigate positive messages that we could send to the kids.
So how exactly does that relate to test prep?
Well, it involves a lot of research, a lot of reading, a lot of writing, and so the kids are involved in making the script and having some ideas on how to present the message to the students.
Now, we're going to take a look at a public service announcement created by Ms. Yaboot's CMI, or Crystal McAuliffe's Investigators, Extended Day Program. Students researched, wrote, and acted in the PSA. Here it is.
Be respectful. Treat people the way you want to be treated. Respect the lowest rank and the highest rank, and you will never get in trouble. Alex Rodriguez.
There is no harm in dreaming of becoming the world's best player. It is all about trying to be the best. I will keep working hard to achieve it within my capabilities. Cristiano Ronaldo.
Lo que me pasó debe enseñar a todos que usted nunca debe renunciar a nadie, David Ortiz.
I like sports because you could try different kind of sports and you could stay fit and active.
I draw because it is a creative way to express myself and it makes me feel important in this world.
I play soccer because I could do awesome tricks and make plenty of friends.
I like to play basketball. I taught myself how to play basketball by watching other people play. And I like it because it makes me feel like I can accomplish something.
I play video games to let my feelings out.
Playing sports show my true personality.
I like to sing because it makes me feel happy and I'm in choir and that it's like my passion is.
I always go outside and practice on soccer. I practice and practice and practice to be the best.
Now for some news from our first floor, PS28. October 30th marked the annual Halloween Day Parade. Students in grades K through 4 participated, dressing up in a wide variety of costumes and marching around the first floor. The PS28 Percussion Ensemble led the parade for the second year in a row. Our own Yasmin Quinones was here to take in all the excitement.
Friday, October 30th, PS28 held a Halloween Day Parade on the first floor. I interviewed Alina Barcero, a fourth grader from Ms. Tosun's class in room 101.
How did you come up with your costume?
Well, I read a book and I saw the girl, she turned pink, and I thought of it because it's very original.
I also had a chance to interview Ms. Pincelli, a third grade teacher at our school.
Well, did you think the kids enjoyed the parade?
I think that I saw lots of smiles, and that's how I knew they were happy. And some children were even dancing.
Did the parade come out the way you wanted it to?
Absolutely. Everybody looked fabulous and happy.
Well, it's amazing how the students and teachers got involved in this wonderful Halloween parade. Everyone just had a wonderful time. Well, this is Crystal McCullough News, Yasmin Quinones, signing off.
Well, it was a very successful fall for our sports teams, wasn't it?
Yes, it was. Our sports producer, Brandon Hartwig, is also a member of the PS28 flag football team. Here he is with the story of the team's historic season.
This fall, the PS28 flag football team had an exciting and historic season. For the first time in school history, the team went undefeated in the regular season. PS28 got off to a fast start by defeating PS27 by a final score of 27-12. The team followed up their victory with an impressive win over last year's Rams division champs, PS39, winning by a score of 30-6. After the game, I spoke with Mr. Abruzzi about the victory.
We're here with Coach Abruzzi. I wanted to know what your thoughts on this.
I couldn't be prouder of a team. We all contributed. You guys practice hard and you deserve to win. I'm very proud of you guys today.
How do you think I did?
What's your name again? No, you did great. You had your first touchdown ever in the Project A team. I'm proud of you, bro. Congratulations.
In the third game of the season, PS28 defeated PS23 decisively 38-13. On the first play of the game, running back Kyle Bandu broke free for a long touchdown run. After the game, I spoke with Kyle about the team's performance. I'm here with Kyle Bandu. Kyle, how do you feel about the touchdown on the first drive?
Well, I feel good. It went really quick for me. Just got the handoff and I went straight down the field for the touchdown. I don't know how else to explain it. It feels good.
On Wednesday, the flag football 28 flag football team will be going against number 7. We're trying to go undefeated for the first time in school history. Here goes 28.
Yeah! In the last game of the regular season, PS28 defeated MS7 by the score of 19-15. 2 weeks later, the teams met again in the second round of the playoffs. In the end, MS7 walked away with a 13-8 victory, knocking PS28 out of the playoffs. It was a very successful year with many players contributing to the team. On offense, quarterback Aaron Avalar threw 10 touchdown passes, 5 of them to receiver Richard Donner. Kyle Bandu led the rushing attack with 3 touchdowns. Defensively, Aaron Avalar intercepted 6 passes and Ronald Conroy had 3 sacks. Having been a member of the team for 3 years, I have enjoyed this season the best. I would like to thank Mr. Puzzi for giving us such a wonderful experience. Reporting for Kristen McAuliffe News, this is Brandon Hartwood. Back to you.
The PS28 track team had another successful year under the direction of Mr. Brown and Mr. O'Donnell. Victoria Peacecheck traveled with the team to the Jersey City Championship track meet. Here's her report.
Wednesday, November 4th, the PS28 track team participated in the Jersey City Track Championship meet.
There she is.
The team had a very successful meet. Diamond Maxwell came in third place in the girls' 100-meter dash. The boys' team also ran well, with the 4x100-meter relay team coming in third place. Mr. O'Donnell was very pleased with the team's results, as well as the way the team represented our school. Congratulations to the team on a job well done.
You know, Mr. Brown and Mr. O'Donnell don't just coach track. They occasionally teach, too.
That's right! This fall, Mr. Brown worked with Mr. O'Donnell's 7th grade science classes on a project that was a blast. We'll let Mr. Brown take it from here.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mr. Brown. I'm reporting live from PS28 school here in Jersey City. Today we have a special groundbreaking event. We will be launching the first rockets of 2009. Let's go see the brains of the operation. So, Mr. O'Donnell, what do we got going on here today?
Well, basically, the kids each year, we have an annual rocket launch competition, sort of. The kids are basically designing a rocket, sustained flight, the longest, and they're all timed. They've built them both in the classroom, a little bit at home. This is a model of Mr. Brown's creation, incorporated our country's NASA. Also, of course, Krista McAuliffe, representing our school. A photoshopped astronaut with myself captured with no oxygen mask. Thank you.
Well, actually, because I work with Mr. O'Donnell, and sometimes he drives me nuts, so I figure let's shoot him up into space. That'll be great. And also, let's get this. The pink... Bring that camera back. Yes, sir. The pink is to match his bunny pink slippers that he wears every night. So, are we ready for our first launch?
With Angel's assistance, I believe we're ready.
All right, let's go see Angel. Angel, what are we doing over here?
We have to record the student and time of the rocket launch.
How you feel about that?
It's fun.
You excited?
Yeah.
Nervous?
A little bit.
Apprehensive?
Maybe.
Maybe? All right, let's see what we got. Are we ready? Are we ready?
What the students need to do is determine basically when they come up here how much, this is like the jet fuel, the propulsion. So they need to determine how much they actually want to put within the rocket. So you're considered the student here. So how much would you like in your rocket, Mr. Brown?
Let's go up to, let's do like a count of three. One, two, three.
All right. You sure?
Yeah. I think let's give it a shot.
All right. So this is our basic launch system here. We have a pump, which basically creates air pressure, which then is contained within the bottle. It'll come to a point where there's too much pressure, it would exceed the plastic, so then, of course, that force needs to be released. So the kids are studying Newton's laws of motion, specifically the third law of motion here, to determine the flight path. We didn't really cover it yet. I let them do the activity to try to find reasoning, then I'll throw in the specific laws of science to justify it. So are you ready?
Holy science, Batman. Are we ready? Okay, children of PS28 school, on my cue, I need you to give me a countdown. Okay, I'll start off and you help me out here. Are we ready?
Yeah.
Wait, do we have to pump it up first, Mr. O'Donnell?
I do, but your count may be a little off, but it's all right.
Okay, are we ready?
Yeah.
Here we go. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, oh, it's up! And down, all right, high five. Nice. So we didn't really get Mr. O'Donnell up into space, but we took him for a little bit of a ride, and hopefully he felt a little bit of pain when he hit that concrete. I'm just kidding. We love you, O'Donnell. We love you. All right, Mr. Kovacs, PS28 community, Mr. Brown here, signing off.
And that's what's been happening here at the Krista McAuliffe School for the first marking period, 2009.
We're going to leave you with a beautiful performance from this year's fall concert by 6th grade choir.
For all of the Krista McAuliffe news team, this is Heaven Scarola.
And May Mansour.
Signing off.